Thank you, Jesus. Welcome again to another section of our Leadership Digest. Today, we are talking about the old man. Everything we are trying to bring to you on this platform is to make you understand the kind of a man that God uses. The kind of a man that God uses. So if you have a calling or you sense the calling of God upon your life and you want to serve in the office of a pastor, a leader in the house of God, we discuss in our previous series that you are no longer for yourself. Today we are looking at another very short message that says, the old man is dead. The old man is dead. Until the old man is dead, you cannot serve God. You might be down there among the receiver, but being among those that will lead from top, that God uses, until you are dead. And anytime the Bible talk about the old man, is referring to the life of sin. We talk in our previous teaching that a man that God uses must do away from his old lifestyle. Change your circle of friends. You can be like them. You can dress like them. You are different from them. The Bible says, in sin we were conceived. Now that you want to serve the life of sin, which is your old nature, must be put to death so that you can serve God. And this teaching is all about the book of Romans chapter 6. Take your time to study the whole chapter of Romans chapter 6, which teaches so much about the life of the old man and the life of the new man. Romans 6 verse 1 says, what shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? To say, God forbid. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? So, until you are dead to sin. There is difference between, I won't sin. You are just saying it, but your body won't it. There are so many things that this body system wants. And many people call it natural. But until you kill the desire of the flesh and open up to the desire of the spirit, your relationship with God at leadership level will be very difficult. Today we have many pastors living in sin and some people cover them up and say it is their weakness. There is nothing called weakness in the Bible. Sin is sin. So, for God to use you, you must be dead. If you are not dead, when sin pinches, you wake up. But when you are dead, sin must come. For instance, if you leave your house today, going out, you can't stop some people from dressing naked. They will see them. You can't say you wake up any day, you don't see anything that seduce you or something that attract you negatively or something that disturb your spirit. You will see them. But a dead man will not be moved by them. What is attracting others will not attract you, because that taste for that, for instance, what on earth will make me smoke? How? But to somebody else, he can't do without smoking. That part that yearn for smoking is completely dead in me. That is how it's supposed to be in every aspect of your life. You want God to use you, and you are. You easily get angry. Any little thing, you are on. Anger. Then you still have a long way to go, because in the service of God as a leader, those you are leading will keep getting you angry. People are not the same. We're different. How can you lead up to 100, 200, 300, or 1,000 people as a leader and expect all of them to be the same? It's not possible. So, it is very important for you to know that. They will get you angry. It is your reaction to their provocation that determines whether that aspect of your life is truly there. And the Bible also said that you cannot be useful until you are dead. In the book of John chapter 12, verse 24. John 12, 24 says, verily, verily, I say unto you, except a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abideth alone. But if it die, it bringeth forth much fruit. Until you are dead, multiplication will not come. You remain alone. Now, if you are privileged to see what a corn of wheat or any crop go through in the soil, the time of dying is a time that nobody wants to see. It's a rough time. A smelling time. It's a painful time. So many of you could be going through your time of death now. Things are dying now. Things are dying. Men are laughing at you. Just allow those things to die. Let them die. You want God to use you? You want to be a good leader? You want to impact your generation? You want to impact your congregation? Whether you are leading 50, 20, 30, even 100, you must go through that process when God take everything away from you. Take it away from you. And he say, until a corn of wheat dies, it abideth alone. So if you don't want to die, then you will be where you are. You cannot multiply. You cannot be useful. You cannot impart. So allow yourself to die. Allow yourself to die. Die to self. Die to sin. Die to evil thought. Die to masturbation. Die to
pornography. Die. You can't be a leader, a pastor, and live in those. You must die. When we say a dead man, they shouldn't mention those things around you. They shouldn't mention them around you. It's not I'm tempted. If today you say you are tempted and it happened, then you're not dead yet. You don't tempt a dead man. He's dead. So we pray in the name of Jesus that you work on yourself today. Let the old man die. Let the old man die. Die to sin. Paul said, shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? The era of grace is seriously interfering with the era of the law. Shall we continue in grace that because we are in the era of grace, then we should accept everything? Pastors living in sin. And we allow, we say it is their weak point. There is nothing called weak point. Let this message, short as it is, impact your leadership lifestyle. Knowing that you are a leader. God told us in our previous teaching that we are the light. They are looking up to us. They are looking up to us. So if we that they are looking up to are still like them, we are not yet dead. What is the hope of those who are looking up to us? I pray in the name of Jesus that we don't dash the hope of our followers. We don't dash the hope of our congregation. We don't dash the hope of our team that we lead. We don't just dash their hope. Pray in the name of Jesus that we be a good leader. Living by example. Be a true follower of Jesus Christ that we profess. That's what Christianity is looking for. Jesus Christ. If Jesus were here, will he do that? Keep asking yourself that question. And God will give you the grace. I don't want to say it is not easy. It is very easy. Because with God, all things are possible. God will give you the grace. God will help you. God will see you through. God will let his light shine upon you. God will make his way more real to you than just letters. Let the life of the world impact you. Let not just the letter of the grammar. Let the light of the world impact you positively. To impact our generation in the mighty name of Jesus. Be a good leader. Keep connecting with us on the Leadership Digest. As the Lord keep us, help us to advance and keep praying for us. That God help us to fulfill this mandate in our own little corner. We are also leading some few people, 10, 20, 30, as it were. If we do well, they will grow and they will multiply. May God help us to lead well in Jesus' name. Praise God.